سيدنا محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم، سيدنا أحمد صلى الله عليه وسلم، سيدنا حميد صلى الله.
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم، الحمد لله رب العالمين، وصلى الله على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. اللهم افتح علينا فتوح العارفين، ووفقنا توفيق الصالحين، وانفعنا اللهم بالقرآن والذكر الحكيم. قال الله تبارك وتعالى في القرآن المجيد: أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم، إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي، يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما. اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد وعلى آل سيدنا محمد، كلما ذكرك الذاكرون وغفل عن ذكرك الغافلون. الصلاة والسلام عليك يا سيدي يا رسول الله، الصلاة والسلام عليك يا سيدي يا حبيب الله، الصلاة والسلام عليك يا سيدي يا نبي الله، وعلى آلك وأصحابك يا سيدي يا خاتم النبيين. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. I will say, and I'm speaking on your behalf, that this is one of the happiest days of my life, our lives, that we have come together to make dhikr of Sayyiduna Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam. And the only thing that has pulled us all together from all backgrounds is the love of Sayyiduna Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam. So why should this not be one of the happiest days of our lives? And as Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam said, he who does not thank people has not thanked Allah. So we begin, and I begin on your behalf again, in thanking our brothers who have organized this event from Sacred Knowledge, most specifically Sidi Khalid, Sidi Yasir, Sidi Imran, Sidi Qasim, and everybody else that has been behind the scenes working, and working hard. And this is an excellent example of a few sincere brothers coming together in order to organize such an event where all of us could come and rejoice in the dhikr of Sayyiduna Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam. And before I commence my talk today, I would also like to welcome our noble young Shaykh, Sheikh Muhammad Wasim, hafidhahullah ta'ala, who has recently returned from the blessed lands of Sham. He has been studying there for the past 6 years continuously. And he is from the excelled students of our noble master and Shaykh, Al-Allama Sayyid Muhammad Abul Huda Al-Yaqubi, hafidhahullah ta'ala. And when he spoke earlier about these gatherings, salawat upon Rasulullah alayhi salatu wasalam, mentioning the names of the awliya Allah, the least I could say about him is he has breathed in the air that these awliya Allah have exhaled. And most specifically, he has sat at the feet of our Shaykh, at the feet of Sheikh Muhammad Al-Yaqubi, hafidhahullah ta'ala, over the past 6 years, benefiting from his words and his hal at masajid and at the residence of the noble Shaykh. Allah Ta'ala increase our Shaykh in Iman and Taqwa, in his struggle for this deen, and allow us all, inshallah, to see him soon when he comes to these shores, inshallah. So I welcome my brother, Sheikh Muhammad Wasim. Allah make your stay here comfortable and allow us to benefit from you. Ameen. I want to start with one hadith of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam. And the topic that I've been given to speak about is seeing him in our dreams. I want to start with this beautiful hadith In the last year of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam's life on earth, he sends out Sayyiduna Mu'adh ibn Jabal radiyallahu ta'ala an to Yemen. So the Messenger of Allah alayhi salatu wasalam walks out with Sayyiduna Mu'adh. Sayyiduna Mu'adh is riding on his camel. And the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wasallam is holding the rein, walking him out of Medina. And the Messenger of Allah alayhi salatu wasalam asks him a few questions. Bima taqdi ya Mu'adh? How will you govern and rule when you come to Yemen, O Mu'adh? He said, by the book of Allah. The Messenger of Allah alayhi salatu wasalam asked him, if you don't find it therein, he said, by the sunnah of the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wasallam. This is a famous hadith. This portion of this hadith is very famous, especially amongst Tulab al-Ilm who study Usul al-Fiqh. When the Messenger of Allah alayhi salatu wasalam completed his nasiha, his advice for Sayyiduna Mu'adh ibn Jabal radiyallahu ta'ala an, the Messenger of Allah alayhi salatu wasalam said a few words to Sayyiduna Mu'adh. And by Allah, these words were heartbreaking. And if we were alive at that time and we were the ones seated on this camel, we wouldn't know how to react at that time. The Messenger of Allah alayhi salatu wasalam said, Ya Mu'adh, O Mu'adh, إِنَّ عَسَىٰ أَنْ لَا تَلْقَانِي بَعْدَ عَامِي هَذَا. It may be that you will not see me again after this year. And the Messenger of Allah is sending him out to Yemen to go and govern these people. But at the same time, the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wasallam is informing him that upon your return, I won't be alive on earth. فَبَكَى مُعَاذٌ جَشَعَ. Sayyiduna Mu'adh burst out crying. He couldn't hold it in, because he's being told by the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wasallam that you will not see me again. And the Messenger of Allah alayhi salatu wasalam calmed him and said, Mu'adh, there is a time to cry and this is not the time to cry. And then the Messenger of Allah alayhi salatu wasalam said beautiful words to him that are hope for all of us. He said, it may be, Ya Mu'adh, that you will return to Medina and you will come past my masjid and my grave. Meaning you will come back to me to come and visit me at my masjid and my grave. And the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam left Sayyidina Mu'adh and he turned back towards Medina. And he said words that are for all of us today. And from the time of the Sahaba to every Muslim that is to come until Yawm al-Qiyamah, he said, sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam, inna awla an-nasi bi al-muttaqoon man kanu wa haythu kanu. The most worthy of being with me are God-fearing people, whoever they are, wherever they may be. And this is hope for every one of us today, that as long as we attain taqwa of Allah Ta'ala, we are worthy of being in the company and at the feet of our beloved master, Sayyiduna Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam. The Sahaba were amazing people. And you have to put yourself in their shoes to imagine how they felt when they lost the Messenger of Allah alayhi salatu wasalam. One beautiful example is Sayyiduna Bilal the Mu'adhin radiyallahu ta'ala an. After the demise of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wasallam, he found it extremely difficult to live in that city of Al-Madinatul Munawwara and see the minbar and see the masjid, and see the home of the Messenger of Allah alayhi salatu wasalam. He decided to leave because it was difficult for him to bear with the loss. So he made his way to the blessed lands of Sham and started to live there. One night he fell asleep, and lo and behold, he saw the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wasallam in his dream. And the Messenger of Allah alayhi salatu wasallam spoke to him. And the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wasallam said, "Ma hadhihi al-jafwa ya Bilal? What is this separation, ya Bilal? What is this separation, ya Bilal, that you live so far away from me? Ama al-ana laka an tazurani? Is it not time that you come and visit me?" Sayyidina Bilal wakes up and immediately sets off from Sham on his way to Madinatul Munawwara because of what he saw in the night before. Rasulullah alayhi salatu wasalam telling him, "Don't you want to come and visit me? Is it not time that you should come and visit me?" He makes his way to Al-Madinatul Munawwara and he comes to the grave of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wasallam. And he starts crying at the grave of the Messenger of Allah, placing his face onto the grave of Rasulullah alayhi salatu wasalam, crying away. And all of a sudden, people start realizing who has come. The word spreads in the streets of Medina. Bilal the Muazzin has returned. People start coming to him, "Ya Bilal, we want to hear the adhan. The adhan that you used to announce and call during the life of the Messenger of Allah alayhi salatu wasalam." But Bilal doesn't have it in him until come the two beloved grandsons of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam, Al-Imam Hassan and Imam Hussein radiyallahu ta'ala anhuma. They come to him, they were young at this time. Sayyidina Bilal sees them and he hugs them. And he kisses them, holding on to them, because they were what reminded him of his beloved, Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam. Then they asked him. They said, "Ya Bilal, natamanna nasma' minka adhan. We wish to hear the adhan from you. The adhan that you used to give for Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam." And Sayyidina Bilal can't turn them away. So he comes to his place where he would give the adhan during the life of the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wasallam. And he calls out, "Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar." And at that time, Medina shook. And when he continues saying, "Ashhadu an la ilaha illallah," people came out of their streets. Men, women, children, everybody came out. They recognized the voice. Mothers left their children. The children asking what had happened. When he said, "Ashhadu anna Muhammadan Rasulullah," people started saying, "Has Rasulullah been sent forth again? Has he come back?" Sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wasallam. Sayyidina Bilal could not complete the adhan. He fell down crying. And the narrators say, never had we seen a day that people cried, men and women, more than that day. The whole of Medina was in tears. Why? Because Sayyidina Bilal saw one dream that made him leave Sham and come to the blessed land of Al-Madinatul Munawwara. Rasulullah alayhi salatu wasalam has for sure left the dunya in the physical form. He sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wasallam gave advice to this ummah and he said to them, to us, that if any of you is ever afflicted with a musibah, any of you is ever afflicted with a difficulty, let him remind himself of the greater loss he has in losing me. Sallallahu alayhi wasallam. No difficulty will now come upon my ummah greater than in losing me. Sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wasallam. He sallallahu alayhi wasallam knows his ummah. And he said to his Sahaba, there will be people that will come after me, that will love me. And they will love me so much that they will give all their wealth away just for one glance at my beautiful face. Sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam. They would give everything up just to see me once. And for us people, inshallah, Rasulullah alayhi salatu wasalam left these beautiful words. He said, whoever sees me in a dream, man ra'ani fil manam, faqad ra'ani, has indeed seen me. فَإِنَّ الشَّيْطَانَ لَا يَتَمَثَّلُ بِي, for shaitan cannot take my form. In another variant, the Messenger of Allah alayhi salatu wasalam said, مَنْ رَآنِ فِي الْمَنَامِ فَقَدْ رَأَى الْحَقَّ, whoever sees me in a dream has seen the truth, meaning he has seen me. In another variant, the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam said, مَنْ رَآنِ فِي الْمَنَامِ فَسَيَرَانِي فِي الْيَقَظَةِ, whoever sees me in a dream shall soon see me in the wakeful state. وَالشَّيْطَانُ لَا يَتَمَثَّلُ بِي, shaitan cannot take my form. There are three parts to note here. Firstly, our Salaf, the Awliya Allah, the Salihin, have mentioned many accounts of them seeing the Messenger of Allah alayhi salatu wasalam with their naked eyes whilst awake. And as we know in Usul al-Hadith, when Sadiqoon come forth with narrations, we don't need to question them. These are people who have the highest level of piety, Awliya Allah. Some of them have come to such an extent that people would say, قَالَ رَسُولُ اللَّهِ صَلَى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمُ in front of them, and they would say, indeed he said such. قَالَ الْحَبِيبِ, the beloved did say such. And the man would say, قَالَ رَسُولُ اللَّهِ صَلَى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمُ, and the Shaykh, the Wali of Allah would say, my Habib did not say such. And this scholar who is mentioning the hadith, he would ask, how do you know? He says, the Wali of Allah, because behind you I see Rasulullah, Habibullah standing. And when you say, قَالَ رَسُولُ اللَّهِ صَلَى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمُ, and I see a smile on his face, I know that these are his words. And when you say, قَالَ رَسُولُ اللَّهِ, and I see displeasure on his face, sallallahu alayhi wasallam, I know these are not his words. Do we not know the works of Imam al-Suyuti in defending the honor and the iman of the parents of Sayyiduna Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam? And according to some scholars, he was given over 20 wakeful visions of the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wasallam. This is the first part to note of these ahadith, that witnessing the Messenger of Allah in our dreams is a fact. And it is possible, more than possible, for people today amongst us to see the Messenger of Allah alayhi salatu wasalam with our naked eyes. The second point is what I read today in the Shama'il of Imam Baghawi with the tahqiq and the ta'liqat of my master and the father of our Shaykh, Al-Allama Qutb Sayyid Ibrahim Al-Ya'qubi radiyallahu ta'ala an wa quddisa sirruh, the father of Sheikh Muhammad Abu al-Huda al-Ya'qubi, hafidhahullahu ta'ala. In his ta'liqat, he mentions under these ahadith that there are two positions amongst the ulama. The first position is, if you see the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wasallam in your dream, you have actually seen him. The second position, which is adopted by Shaykh al-Akbar Muhyiddin ibn Arabi, and then taken from Shaykh al-Akbar by Mujaddid al-Fithani, Shaykh Ahmad Sirhindi radiyallahu ta'ala anhuma, is that it's only when you see the Messenger of Allah alayhi salatu wasalam in your dreams, like we read in the Shama'il, is when you have seen him. Only then can shaitan not take the form of the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wasallam. And the third point to note, that this is not merely news that the Messenger of Allah is giving to us, that whoever sees me has indeed seen me. Rather, this is hope, encouragement for every one of us, that if you are ready, You will see me in your dreams. If your eyes are pure, your heart is yearning, you will indeed see me in your dreams. If you missed that time of seeing the Messenger of Allah alayhi salatu wasalam in his physical form in Madinatul Munawwara over 1400 years ago, then do not despair. You could see me in your dreams. These are glad tidings given by Rasulullah alayhi salatu wasalam to all of us. And I want to finish with the example our Shaykh, Shaykh Muhammad Al-Ya'qubi, Hafizahullah Ta'ala gave, I believe at this minbar, about seeing the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam. A student came to his teacher and he said to his teacher, I want to see Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam in my dreams. The teacher accepted and a few days later invited him to his home. And he gave him the evening meal, which was salty food. And salty food makes you more thirsty. And then the Shaykh gave him water to drink, but the water was salty. So salt upon salt made his thirst even more. But the murid, the student being a well-mannered student, didn't ask the Shaykh for water. He went to sleep, feeling thirsty. In the morning, when they rose, the Shaykh asked him, what did you see last night? The student said, I saw ponds and rivers and seas and oceans. I saw water. Why did he see water? Because he was yearning for water. The Shaykh then told him, when you will yearn for Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam like you yearned for water, you will see Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam. Allahu Akbar. The Messenger of Allah alayhi salatu wasalam said, the beloved people of Allah are those hidden people that when they are absent, they're not remembered. When they are absent from a gathering, they're not remembered. And when they are seated, they're not noticed. That doesn't include me, because I'm noticed, but includes all of you. It may be amongst us there are chosen people that who will be given this vision and who have already been given this beautiful vision of seeing our beloved Rasul, Sayyiduna Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam. I pray for you and for myself that Allah Ta'ala purifies our heart out of His bounty and purifies our eyes and makes us worthy of seeing His beloved Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam. I leave you with these words, وَمَا تَوْفِيكِ إِلَّا بِاللَّهِ وصلى الله على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين والحمد لله رب العالمين بارك الله فيكم.